and the trip. I was pretty hesitant at first to go, just because I knew we were going to places that are pretty fickle. It's either it's going to pump or you're just going to get pretty much nothing. And just putting a lot of money down for something like that in such a short time, I knew that if I didn't really score on this trip, then a lot of my money had been blown for the rest of the year.
So when we got to the Philippines, I heard it could be a pretty fickle place, pretty small a lot of the time and stuff. And when we got there, it was just dead flat. And looking at the charts, like the 7-day forecast, it wasn't showing anything going on. So 3 days passed and we were stressed out a bit. We ended up going down to these caves, and they were pretty amazing. The boat right there was on this little shanty town looking boat. And the next day, we kind of woke up to a little bit of swell. And then the day after that, it was just pumping. And on the charts, it was just saying 1 to 2 foot, nothing going on. But we just got, I think it was 4 or 5 days, 4 to 5 foot just pumping.
Oh,
night we went into town, we could hear some guys singing up the road, so we're like, oh, we've got to check it out, see what's going on. So we went up there and Jake had a couple of beers and he's getting a little cocky, as he does. Jake turns up, starts growling into the mic, just screaming down. He did his hardcore version of Bohemian Rhapsody and was having people that were walking down the street were stopping and coming over. I reckon by the end of it, he probably had 30 people around the karaoke. And he's just going nuts into the mic. And he did it for about 2 hours. He just couldn't get enough of it.
Nothing really matters at all. Yeah, come on.
Karaoke was definitely beer influenced. I didn't want to get drunk, and next thing I know, Chris James is buddy buying me Golden Eagles left, right, and centre. Led to another. Next thing I know, I was doing death growls in front of the whole town. Everyone's looking at me like, who is this fucking idiot?
Basically, Ireland was a place of broken promises. Ireland's the kind of place that you don't want anything to go wrong because you're going to pay for it, and it's going to be euros, which is going to be double. Apparently, we had all this organised stuff organised, and once we got there, we basically had nothing. We were just on the street. During the first week, we kind of got some fun ways, little right hands and stuff like that, but definitely not something that you come to Ireland for. But it was everything I'd expected at that time. It was raining every day. It was cloudy. It wasn't as cold as I thought, but it was just, you know, it wasn't a paradise, that's for sure. Then the maps were starting to look pretty good down in the south, so we headed down there. Sunny skies, offshores, and just pumping waves. The highlight was probably those cliffs. They were just out of control. I didn't want to have anything to do with them. The other highlight was the dolphin. That thing was out of control. I didn't really want to have anything to do with that either. The thing was hectic, it was massive. It was just, I like dolphins, but you know, I think I've watched too many when animals attack videos, when pets turn bad and everything goes downhill. Yeah, that dolphin was just way too friendly. It was just crazy. Experience-wise, it was amazing, you know. Just this dolphin playing for about 2 hours. It was just playing with us and then with the photographers and coming back out. But yeah, I just didn't want to go near the thing. Trust nothing and no one.
Thank you.
flow rider was insane. Like, I've never been on one before. Just everyone was talking up about how pumped you're gonna get. We turned up and Jake's a freak on it. He just picked it up so quick, and he was just, within like an hour, he was just shredding over everyone and making us all look like fools. In the end, like, we all like got it together and starting to link up moves. It's just so different to surfing on a real wave. And we ended up getting 5 hours on it. Just by the end of it, I was so sore, I just got so nervous. Landing on my neck and just being in the weirdest position. That night I was just in so much pain, and the next morning none of us could walk. After the flow rider, it was time for me to go home. All the boys are going to Mexico. I don't think there's anything good about that place, so I just called it quits and got home. Like, he's just talking up this closeout the whole time, like going, oh, I can't wait to get to Mexico. Don't worry, boys, we'll be there in Mexico soon.
So Mexico, pretty much from the start of the trip I was so amped just to get here because it's like a second home to me. I love just being here and it's just cheap and there's just pretty much always pumps, and I've just been telling the fellas the whole time, don't worry, just wait till we get to Mexico, wait till we meet Mexico, it's just going to be pumping. So we get to Mexico and it's not pumping. Oh, for some reason, there's swell, but it's just out the front, as you can tell, it's just not really doing it, and Colorado's just not really doing it, it's just weird, so we're just a bit unlucky at the moment, but we've still got another a week, so we can see what happens. I don't want a Tucson girl, what I want is a shining dime. Come on now.
was hanging out. Her eyes drifted off to the other side. Well, the last straw's been drawn. The last flight is gone and I'm on board. I was seated in seat 7C with an old man looking up at me.
Basically, we're here in Mexico. I've been telling the fellas, sit doesn't get below 6 foot the whole time you're there, offshore every day, sun out, cheap as chips, you name it, it's all going to happen in Mexico. As you can see, it's onshore, 2 foot and straight. What's happening? Got another week, fingers crossed. I've got my favourite lucky towel here, so that thing's helped us along the way, so it's all good. Viva la Mexico!
Matthew Shane, Nomad Lackey, he's pretty much the biggest net fiend I know. All he does is surf, eat, net, that's it. Occasional sleep. Maybe not sleep because he likes talking to chicken, yeah. So we'll just go see what he's doing right now. Matthew Lackey, how you going, mate? As you can see, on the net again.
Surf, eat, shit, sleep, and internet. Mexico.
He's got his granola. There's his granola.
Got my granola, mate. Got my headphones for my Skype. Got me lappy. Got me wireless. Don't bother me. Pikey's for life, mate.
Just a lie.